What's up, Lubinati? I've been getting tons of questions in my DMs over the last couple weeks about everything from what is a lockout, why is it gonna happen, the specifics of it, down to just in general understanding what is going on. So let's get started. Okay, the next questions, I got a bunch actually on these. How does this affect free agents? Well, everything is on pause, which means that agents, teams, they can't negotiate anymore. They cannot sign anymore until there is no longer a lockout. Now, players that have already signed, they're good to go. They have a contract waiting depending on when season starts. Can players negotiate with teams during this period? No. No communication. Now, is that to say that it will not happen? No, you know, anything can happen, but technically, there cannot be any communication. Everything has to stop and be put on pause. Can new players signed be introduced in press conferences during the lockout? Unfortunately, no. That's why you see, you know, there's a fair amount that are happening very quickly right now before the lockout, because again, if there is a lockout, nothing will kind of continue as normal. What about winter meetings? So if there is a lockout, there will not be winter meetings, and that is because MLB isn't going to sanction an event where work would be done when there's a lockout going on. Can teams trade players amongst each other during this time? The answer is no, all transactions are going to have to stop. So even though that doesn't involve the players and their agents and like the player side of things, and it's just between two teams, those transactions will have to stop as well. Another question was, can teams still cut or waive players, or do they have to stop that too? Correct, they have to stop that too. Everything is on pause. What happens if teams can't make deals with their arbitration players? So the arbitration process is going to be messed with a bunch if this continues on into January. There are key dates like the filing, exchange deadline, etc., that are upcoming that will be affected. Now, you saw that both sides agreed to do the, you know, tender deadline on November 30th to make sure at least that was done. But in terms of, you know, filing numbers, none of that will happen. Once an agreement is made, then the MLBPA and MLB will have to come up with and agree upon a new calendar and a much more accelerated calendar in order to do the filing, you know, exchange deadline and any potential hearings. Next question is, this is a great one, is how does this affect minor leaguers? The answer is it won't affect them, and that is because they're not on the 40-man roster, so they are not technically governed by the MLBPA. They are not a part of the union. Now, what's going to happen and what usually happens is, let's say we get all the way up until spring training and there's still no agreement and there's a lockout. Owners and teams will try to get their affiliates, you know, the minor leagues, to get the players to agree to play in the big leagues for these teams instead, since they're normal big leaguers are not playing right now. Now, if this happens, and it's happened in the past where minor leaguers are like, you know what, some are like, this might be my only shot getting to play in the big leagues, so I'm gonna do it. They are called scabs. And what happens is, if they decide to become a scab, then they forfeit the ability to ever be a member of the MLBPA. Now, what that means is, let's say, you know, fast forward another year or two, now there's a new CBA and everything is great, and these scabs now make it to the big leagues, you know, on their own, and they start accruing service time. They won't be eligible to get pension or anything like that that the CBA, the union, provides to them, to players, to members of the union, because they have forfeited their ability to be a member of the union by essentially going against what, you know, the union and the players are fighting for. Somebody asked, if a lockout happens, will it affect Manfred's status as sitting commissioner? No. His job is, you know, to essentially do the bidding for the owners and, you know, negotiate on their behalf. You know, the owners could decide for any reason to, you know, get rid of the current commissioner, but, you know, a simple lockout isn't going to change his position unless they decide for another reason that they don't want him as commissioner anymore. Will it hurt the game of baseball? Absolutely. Because I think we saw this during the COVID-19 negotiations last year. When fans start to feel like, you know, you've got the rich and the richer arguing over money, and the fans, who are really, you know, what drives the whole industry, are missing out on the ability to see baseball games, etc., a lot of resentment is built up. And yeah, it will end up affecting the game of baseball, no doubt. Will it be as bad as the 95 strike? You know, look, like, depending on how long it lasts, obviously that had a huge effect on the game of baseball. But again, that was the season. It was a strike and the season was halted. Now it's during the offseason. So there is this buffer period where a deal can be done and maybe, you know, nothing is affected in terms of the 2022 season. I got a million questions on how long will it last. It depends. There's a lot of tension between both sides. And so if the players really do want to fight for the changes that they believe need to happen, then it could last a while. Let's hope it doesn't. Somebody asked, is there a, you know, minimum length that a lockout would have to last? Nope, not at all. Once a deal is agreed upon, you know, the owners could lift the lockout whenever. It could be days and it could be, you know, months. Does this mean spring training will be pushed back? If there is no agreement, you know, and we start getting into February, then yeah, they will have to start rescheduling and figuring out what the 2022 season will look like. Do I think that the lockout is a real threat to actual games being canceled in 2022? I'd like to be optimistic right now and say, I think, you know, a deal will get done. It could happen. I think if we look at just this, you know, past year during COVID and the shortened season and what those negotiations looked like, I don't think many people thought we would end up with just a 60-game season like we did. So anything could happen. I know it's not the season yet, but do players get paid during the lockout? So players right now aren't getting paid, even ones on contract, they just get paid during the season. So it's not going to affect any players at the moment. However, if games are suspended for the 2022 season, then yes, it will affect players getting paid. They will not get paid by their contracts and by the clubs. Rather, they will get paid by the MLBPA, who has essentially saved up every CBA. They get membership dues, and some of the licensing money that is made by the union goes into this war chest. And this war chest is what is going to help cover players during any potential work stoppage. Have players been saving up and preparing for a long lockout? Yes, every cycle throughout the CBA, the union is saving up money to prepare players and make them feel like they will be okay if there is a work stoppage and they don't need to lower their standards simply because they're worried that they won't have money coming in. And again, let's remember that more than half of the league right now is getting paid under $1 million. So again, that is still a lot of money, but let's not just like assume that everyone is making millions and millions and has made millions and millions and that there's no reason that they can't go a year without money. How will it affect me and other agents? We just have to, you know, keep communication open with our players, make sure that they understand what's going on, make sure that they have contingency plans, and then, you know, you just kind of wait and see. Obviously, if it affects salaries, that will affect their, you know, income as well. Anyways, I hope that was helpful, guys. If you have more questions, shoot them my way and I will try my best to answer some more. But fingers crossed that we have a full and normal 2022 season.